knows
that I ain't going
nowhere.
I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should have known it. I wasn't going.
What's up, everybody? Makeup Janelle here. So if this is your first time to my channel, welcome, welcome, welcome. Honestly, on my channel, I really just try to make you guys feel beautiful with makeup and just try to give you a little insight on my life. I have my beautiful best friend here. This is Brie Michelle. I just beat her face if y'all can't tell. Okay. So yes, how long have we been best friends?
I think over 10 years now, maybe 10 years.
So we've been
because you know me long time.
So, yeah. long time. We definitely have, our friendship has gradually got stronger over the years. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, when did I even start calling you my best friend? I don't even know.
I think within the past 3 years.
You think so?
Mm-hmm.
I think you're right, because mm-hmm. we've been through a lot. Even with COVID and everything.
We was each other's backbone during COVID, baby.
So how would you explain, or how would you, if you were explaining this to other women, how do you think we maintain such a good friendship and a healthy friendship? How do you think we do that?
I think, and I'm just thinking, I think that we love each other the way that we receive love, like what your requirement is. Mm-hmm. So you know the five love languages: physical touch, affirmations, acts of service, quality time, mm-hmm. And gifts. You know my love languages: affirmations and quality time, mm-hmm. and physical touch. So you give me a lot of quality time, affirmations, and a little bit of physical touch. And I yes. think because we took the time to understand each other's love language, we love each other that way, and then we learned each other's boundaries. Mm-hmm. We also know when each other is telling each other, you know, like feedback or any criticism, we don't take it too personal. And yeah. when the other one does something that offends the other one, we're like, hey, because remember that time you made me mad? And I was like, you really rubbed me the wrong way. And he's like, oh my god, I didn't mean to. I'm like, you yes, did.
I rubbed her the wrong way.
I was able to pull you to the side and tell you, mm-hmm. friend, you really kind of like made me upset.
Yeah.
Well, so I'm talking about the pain
we were,
vibe.
Yeah.
You were like, oh, really? I'm like, yes. Oh, girl, my bad. It was very harmless, but
I still rubbed you the
She didn't get offended.
Yes.
Yeah, it wasn't simple. I was like, F her. I was just like, oh, she pissed me off. But I get what you were saying.
Yeah.
At that time. So, mm-hmm. yeah. So I think that's how we keep a healthy relationship. Also feel like we respect each other's boundaries. Like, she does my makeup, I pay her. You know, I get to pay my discount, but I pay. And you know, when somebody else is paying, they pay the full price. I come on time to the appointment. She comes on time to mine. Mm-hmm. I try to cancel. I try to let her know, friend, I think I want my makeup done, but give me a chance to tell you.
Yeah.
Don't block it off. Somebody else books, I get it. So I think we just keep those boundaries. I don't just feel like, oh, because she's my best friend, I can fucking mess up her business.
Yeah. So. I definitely think that boundaries is a wonderful way that we maintain a good, solid friendship, because I know a boundary for you may be your business and mm-hmm. how you operate and run your business. So
yeah.
If I don't really just offer my opinion sometimes unless she asks for it. That's the only time
I'm like,
really,
I need your opinion.
Yes. She'll tell me, hey, friend, I need your opinion. What do you think about such and such? Otherwise, even when it comes to you being a parent, I don't have kids, so I definitely respect your boundaries on how she does parents. And because what can I possibly say?
No, remember when you told me not to feed Skylar the salmon?
Oh, she
you was like, but she doesn't like that
she
salmon.
Like
I don't
salmon,
like the salmon.
But
I don't give it to her anymore.
But
I was like, whatever.
You know what? I may not want to cook separate meals for my child. And I'm like, what can I possibly say? So
I don't give it to her no more, though.
I definitely think we do a really, really good job at respecting each other's boundaries. I also think that we pour into each other on a daily.
We do. And I think I naturally try to pour into people in general. People, even my clients sometimes, I pour into them. And I think that's something natural that you do as well.
Yeah.
I think a lot of women get in these friendships and they don't want to pour into their friends because maybe they don't want to help their friend get better in life, or maybe they just, you know, a little standoffish. I think women are distant to other women because of so much trauma and so much negative stuff that has happened to them throughout different friendships. And that's probably why they're kind of just like, eh, that's just my friend, but I'm not going to pour into her.
I think that...
Or maybe they need to pour into themselves and they probably can't pour into their friend.
Knowing that one of your love languages is words of affirmation, I feel like I have to pour into her like that, whether if it's calling her beautiful or just telling her she's doing a great job, she's being a great mother, she's doing all that she can, and just let her know how special she is, because I know that's her love language. So I think we both equally, you know, pour into our friendship. I think you may be a little bit more passionate than me sometimes.
I am.
Because she is like... friend, like, it's very, very, very passionate. So I have to...
Is it overwhelming? Because I told a client and somebody else of mine how I need affirmations weekly, or if not weekly, a couple of times out the month. And I was like, my best friend gives it to me. And they were like, girl, I could not be your friend. I'm like, she doesn't have to, but she does.
Yes.
Is it overwhelming?
I think certain conversations can be overwhelming.
Okay. You know what I need to start doing? And I've seen this on YouTube. Before you call your friends with problems, you need to say, hey, friend, I do need to lay some info and stuff out to you that's about me. Mm-hmm. Are you mentally able to handle this right now?
Yeah, I don't think women do that. I don't ask. We just call and we just start venting.
Yeah, we just start venting. But you may be going through something.
True.
But... I always think you're not going through anything.
She thinks I'm just at home doing nothing.
I'm like, you're not like doing nothing, girl.
Just at home doing makeup all day. Like, no.
But I think we should start doing that.
Yes.
Because what if mentally that friend can't take on the negative stuff you're about to tell them?
Yes.
And I think that's what's happened with me in the past with other friendships. And I became the person that thinks that friend is toxic. And they probably weren't being toxic. They just were going through something. And at the time, I wasn't able to receive what they were going through because... mentally, I wasn't there.
Yes, but I do think just over time, I just have learned her. And just with time, I choose to learn her. I choose to figure out what she likes and what she don't like. It's just a learning process.
Yeah, you hate seafood. That's why I don't take you anywhere where it's all seafood.
I do not like seafood. So
I look at the menu.
She'd be like, look, Janelle, they ain't got no seafood. Or so you not gonna eat here. So we.
I'm like, you ain't gonna eat here. They ain't got no seafood.
I agree. Sometimes I do think that another way that we maintain our friendship is just minding our business sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes I mind my business with her. I'd be like,
look, friend, do what's best for you. But
I got drunk once and I couldn't mind my business about something she had going on, and I was just pouring my heart out to her about it.
Pouring.
And it was two people there. Mm. It was my boyfriend at the time, and it was my guy best friend, Mark. Hey, Mark. And my boyfriend at the time was getting so mad. I was being so passionate. He was like, why are you going so hard? I'm like, because I am. And Mark was like, I get it. I know why you are. You love her. He was like, you love her. I know you care. He was like, she has to see for herself.
Yes.
I'm like, I don't like it. I'm just going off. And I'm yelling and probably spitting in her face. And she just was not. She was just like, I get it.
And
man.
I was just standing there.
But I was drunk.
There. And I understood that. I understood.
And okay. You were talking about him. And I was like.
I know. Like, I understood. She was little intoxicated. I understood.
Them drinks was good, girl. We gotta go back there. Sports social.
We do. I understand where it was coming from, but at times, your delivery.
Is I know.
Very, very passionate.
Yeah, because I did it again on Jackie's birthday. And I meant no harm. But I'm just like, I want her to see it's not me tripping.
But
and I know she just has to learn, but she's seeing it for what it is.
Yes, but let me tell y'all, she'll be like, no, Janelle, you're that, like, you need to know. Like, and I think at times as women, we need to hear that because...
Oh, I'm always telling you, I'm like, you're gorgeous. You see, everyone's right? Doing the same thing.
And I'm like, you know what? She really be pouring into me. But like I said, you have to know... when it's sometimes to be like, okay, friend, we'll just do what you want to do.
I just know, and I think I was telling somebody this, you're a good person.
Yeah.
And I've had friends I know who don't deserve the person they're with, or I feel like they're not a great of a person, and that's why the relationship is not working with you. I seen you in relationships. You're a good person. She's loyal.
I am.
So when somebody's trying to play you, I'm like, no, you're better than that. You ain't ghetto than them. You ain't like me. You ain't cursing them out. You ain't passing gas in front of you're not me.
Okay, it's okay.
So when they try to play you, I'm like, no, she deserves better. And I think that's why I be going so hard. I'm like, no, she's a really good girlfriend and a good friend. This the best it's gonna get.
I think that we both love each other through through just flaws and yeah, because it's difficult at times, right?
It is. Well, not really with you.
You don't think so?
I think in the gym you get on my nerves to a certain extent.
But I'm going to push her in the gym. Like, yeah. She ain't got nobody else that's going to push her, so why not?
But I just ignore you. I'm in the gym like, oh.
I like our quality time in the gym.
No, I do, but she get on my nerves to a certain extent. Because okay. She's like, no, do it like this. Do this. I'm like, oh.
Well, that's why you have a trainer.
Yeah.
And he got on my nerves too. So it's okay.
I'm talking about when we worked out together, like, in the gym that few times we worked out. I was like,
she don't like the way I work out.
Yeah. You had me squatting with the bar. I'm just like, ugh.
So where do you see our friendship going in the next, I don't know, maybe 5-7 years?
5-7 years. I thought you was gonna say like 20 years. I'm gonna say gracias, no, golden just, girls.
Okay, I get that. But like, in 5 or 7 years, we'll be pushing our 40s.
And I see you possibly like maybe engaged.
Yeah, engaged.
Possibly pregnant.
Oh!
Yeah, I think, no, I'm serious. It ain't gonna be me, Chad.
Okay.
I see that. Yeah. I see you further along in your career and doing other things that have nothing to do with beauty.
I agree.
But I still feel like we'll still be friends. Mm-hmm. I see me hopefully married. And you married too.
Okay.
Not just engaged.
Just, no, this is good. I'll just be working towards a future.
I just see us accomplishing more. I see us very busy, where we may not have time for each other, but I see us very busy, because in a couple of years, by then I'll be in nursing school, but I feel like we'll still make enough time to see each other. Yeah.
Whether we FaceTime.
No, yeah, because you know how I am. I'm gonna find a way, even if I'm calling you on lunch break.
She's gonna call
school is getting on my nerves.
And tell me about her whole day, okay? Mm-hmm. She's gonna call me and just recap the whole past
Everything.
2 days. That's what she's going to do.
But I think even if you was to get like married before me, we could still be friends.
Absolutely.
Because I'm friends with married people, and I know boundaries. Like, even with Reese, if her husband walks in, I'm like, okay, girl, I'll call you tomorrow. Like, I give her space. I think friends don't know boundaries when they're, like, somebody's in a relationship. I'm like, okay, have fun, because I know you got to spend time.
Yes.
I don't feel like I'm that friend that's like, oh, she's married now, we can't be cool.
I think we're both at a place where we're trying to balance and just continuing to balance a healthy friendship. Whether we're dating, in a relationship, not going to networking events, we're really just trying to balance everything. Yeah. So anybody that's out there, if you have a best friend or just a group of women around you, try to pour into them. Also do some self-reflecting as well. We're both in therapy. So we both can look at ourselves and figure out what we're doing wrong, work on our communication.
Really, and I slip back sometimes.
It's okay. I do too. But really just try to work on yourself so you can pour into the women around you. So,
do you feel like within the next couple of years you'll make more friends?
You know what? That's very interesting, because I don't have a wonderful big group of friends. Usually your friends become my friends sometimes. Yeah. She has a lot of friends. Lots and lots of friends, but I've never had.
I've known a lot of them for years, or like I'll know them from like previous jobs that I worked at, and we just, me and that person always connected.
Yes.
Because I'd be talking to people.
I think so.
Or clients turn into friends like that.
I can see that. I can see some of my clients turning into my friends, or people that I would bring to a birthday dinner or whatever the case may be. I do see myself acquiring a few more friends. So, yeah.
I have a lot of friends, but I also have a lot of associates, and I had to put, and then I have best friends. I had to put people in categories. So I don't feel like I have that many friends.
Because
I don't want to be that girl that has so many friends. Like, okay, girl. I don't hang with different cliques, though.
Yeah, but you can have a party and invite 15 people. I can't do that.
You actually could.
I probably can if I really thought hard about it.
Yeah, you could.
Yeah, because most of my would be probably clients and because a lot of
but
my
clients turn friends.
That is very, very true. So, but I'm not even friends with anybody I went to high school with or anything.
I am Sashi.
No, I'm definitely.
Yeah, I am Sashi.
I want you to tell YouTube your handles and where they can find you.
I forgot it. No, I'm just playing. Okay, so I'm on YouTube as Bree Michelle. 1-8, I'm sorry. Because I didn't think about it. But Bree Michelle 1-8. Instagram, Bree Michelle 1-8. TikTok, Bree Michelle 1-8. I like the 1-8 because my birthday is July 18th. And I'm also going to post this video on my YouTube channel.
Yeah.
So you guys can like, comment, and subscribe to mine as well. And then, of course, hers. Yeah. And then definitely put comments below. of more content that you want to see her put on her channel. Because I know she does a lot of makeup and beauty stuff and get ready with me. But you guys may want to see more of her talking. More of her talking about different topics and different things. You know, YouTube, I feel like a lot of people be on there who don't even have Instagram and TikToks at the time. And they just search different things.
Yeah.
I do think talking about female friendships and relationships is important because it's a struggle.
It is, trying to find good women
who are not in competition with you, who want to see you win. I think you, out of every friend I've ever had, I think is the only, not only friend, but one of the major friends I have that has never been in competition with me, has never done nothing like ill will. She ain't over here making, doing my makeup funny because she want me to look better than her. When she gives compliments, I'm like, yeah, the bitch, I'm like, she gorgeous. I ain't hating, you know what I'm saying? And I think it's hard. Sometimes you'll be friends with people and if you get more compliments, they're jealous.
They're feeling some type of way, right?
Yeah, no. Because there's times where we out and they're like, oh my gosh, she's gorgeous. They're like, oh, your body to me. So it's like, it's I'm like, okay, you got your short hair, bitch. They eating on you. When I get mine, they be on me too. But yeah, so you got to be very mindful and selective of who you put into your circle, into your space, because of energy. You're Gemini, I'm a Cancer. I think I know a lot of Gemini. I guess I get along with Gemini.
I guess you do get along with Geminis because you have a few in your life.
I do.
But she's a special one, you guys. She's a very special
one. Everybody thinks I'm special.
She is very, very special.
I love hard.
You do love hard. I think that's the best attribute you don't think that you, love you hard? Have about yourself. At times, yeah. But I don't love like you. I don't be as passionate about like as you, I don't think.
I wonder why I'm like that.
Like, I can be a bit dry sometimes.
I know. So. But that could be a mechanism. Sometimes they
say people, coping or trying to deal with something.
Yeah, they said, I've seen this before, that they say when you're dry, it's because that's your, like, wall.
Yeah, you're right. Sometimes. Because sometimes I don't be wanting to talk. I just rather sit back and listen.
Yeah, because Natasha's a Gemini and she can be wall, but when she's in her feelings, I'll hear her talking about something sweet and she'll start crying.
Exactly.
So she ain't that hard. Hey, girl. Hey, Natasha.
But thank you guys so much for tuning in. Please make sure you hit the like, subscribe button. Definitely drop some comments below of more content that you would like for me to post. Make sure you follow my bestie, Bree Michelle 18, on all her social media platforms. But until next time, you guys, bye.
I ain't blowing no smoke. I mean, I've been sober, but you should've known it. I wasn't going.